So Donald Trump got COVID, Joe Biden didn't. Arguably because Joe Biden actively tries not to. For instance, by social distancing and by wearing a mask. And he continues to try to remind people of that. For instance, with this video that his campaign put out yesterday. Look that up online. The full video of just Joe Biden putting on the mask has like rock music, and the entire thing makes me feel really uncomfortable. I guess you have to really love Joe Biden for that to be for you. But anyway, I agree with the message. It's a simple one. Wear a mask so you won't shed the virus and you'll protect yourself from getting it. For some people though, that video, nay, that request that you wear a mask is effeminate, including Tomi Lahren, who tweeted, "Might as well carry a purse with that mask, Joe." And I hate it. I hate it so much. I hate everything. Not about like her. She's a grifting robot. Like she's not a, you know, she doesn't exercise free will. She's just doing whatever she thinks will get her paid. But Jordan, like the fact that Trump got coronavirus and they still think wearing a mask is something that little sissy boys do, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, this really goes back to kind of the hyper-masculine stuff that we talked about earlier. The debate had that moment where Trump insulted Biden for wearing a mask. Oh, this guy wears the biggest mask I've ever seen. Immediately proceeds to catch COVID, goes home, takes off the mask. And now it's you're somehow less of a man, or you know, this is kind of a hyper masculine trope here by Tommy. But like, oh, you got to be carrying a purse if you wear a mask. Like, what is that? Who does that serve? And it's at some point, like, I have to wonder if this is all just an act. She can't be that dumb. Like, is she to get this far? I mean, she's successfully navigated right wing media circles and different organizations for years. Like, she's not inept. I think she's just like really, really in the tank for the GOP. Like that's, if that's your thing, like whatever. It's not what I would want to do. I want to make an honest living. But like she's just like clearly a right wing reactionary who will do and say and whatever to defend the right wing. This is absurd.
Yeah.
I refuse to believe she's that dumb. She's just entirely disingenuous.
I agree, and she is, you know, we are living in Grift Nation. Everybody needs to understand it. There are true believers, like there are on the right. They're crazy, insane, racist, all of that. But like they really do project that they really believe this. But I get from her that she does what all grifters do. She analyzes the landscape, identifies a desire, and just does the thing that those people want her to do. And so what those people want, and those people, by the way, are right-wing white males. They want a woman who will tell them constantly that women are bad and certainly not as good as men. That's what these men want. They want men that will tell them that women suck, but they especially want women that will tell them that women suck. And so Tomi Lahren is doing the thing that Ann Coulter did for several decades. Just saying that women suck, they're awful, they're emotional, they shouldn't be in positions of leadership, they probably shouldn't even be able to vote. That's what she's doing here. She's sort of dipping her toe in the water, but she's saying women are weak, being like a woman is weak and stupid. And so Joe Biden wearing a mask is weak like a woman's weak. Even though, important reminder, Trump got COVID and Biden didn't. That would seem to be a point in Biden's favor, but apparently not from Tomi Lahren, because Tomi Lahren doesn't care that much about people getting COVID. She cares about having knuckle dragging white conservative males continue to watch her show. You know, and I could say more, I'm not going to, I'm gonna end it right there. There's more to it than just that, but that's what she wants. And the reason I show this really is not to point out to people that Tomi Lahren is a horrible grifter or whatever. Everybody knows that. It's, will anyone learn from Trump getting COVID? And I guess not if you're getting paid not to. You know, if you're getting paid to tell people that masks are a hoax thought up by China and, you know, Bill Gates, then no, I guess at this point you're probably not gonna learn and you're not gonna suddenly become responsible in this way.
Yeah, and this exemplifies this kind of this trope that, oh, Trump beat COVID, he's tougher than COVID, all that kind of stuff. This is like, this is, you know, the ultimate distillation of that. Like, not only did he do it, he's a man for not even wearing a mask. He's not even scared of it, things like that. And, you know, she's well connected in right wing media circles. She works at Fox. So this is just like, it shows just even there, from there to kind of like the fringes, like they're all, this is going to be their talking point now.
Yeah. Yeah. Really fast, I don't know, I've probably said this on the show before. So I've only had two interactions with Tomi Lahren really in my life, maybe tweets or something like that, but I blocked that out. She had me on her show way back, I think on The Blaze, and it was a segment about Hillary Clinton. And all I got from that impression was that, man, she really hates Hillary Clinton. But that was pretty much it. It was a short thing. I've only ever talked to her once in person. And we had a little conversation. And you know what she was like in person?
Was she nice?
Perfectly fine. She's perfectly nice. Totally nice. You know why? Because there were no fans to make one way or the other from being nice to me or not being nice to me. And so I guess she was just nice to me. There was no money on the line. No image to carefully craft. There was just a human interaction. And in that way, she was fine. I'm sure if I dug deep, there's a lot of bad stuff there, but she was a perfectly fine person. But this is what grift does to people. You have to craft the persona that gets you paid, even if that persona is objectionably, it's just the worst. It's just the worst. You get paid to be bad. That's a bad system, I think.
Yeah.
God, man.
The media ecosystem is it's so toxic. Like, I'm sure if there was a camera around, she would be more blunt with you. But like,
totally, yeah, totally.
It's she's just putting on a performance in that kind of a situation, you know. Like that's it's just, but it does everyone a disservice when we have that kind of a scenario. Like, you know, it started with Crossfire, and really took off with Crossfire. Like, they're not there to debate. So it's like, I don't like to talk to people from other outlets because they're not really looking for an actual conversation about things like this is. What's the point? I don't want, if you want to argue with me, you just kind of like resort to like bad faith attacks. It's a waste of my time. You see this kind of stuff a lot with like YouTube debates. Not really of interest to me. I think there's a bunch of people who like to like debate right wingers and alt-right people on YouTube. It's a waste of time because it's all performance. No one's going to be like, you know what? I changed my mind at the end. It's a waste. It's an absolute waste. It's all for entertainment.
I couldn't agree more. I said that many times on the show. I do think there are people who really do believe that engaging in that will change minds. I know of at least one person who is actually genuine. I think that person is wrong. I don't think it has that effect. 9 out of 10 people who do that, though, whether they're good or bad at it, that's a different thing. And if you just want that entertainment, then fine, watch it. It's, you know, arguably as good as watching a Fast and Furious movie in terms of its effect on the country. But it is just performance. It's brand building. It's arguably clout chasing. That's all it is. Not to say that nobody's ever had their mind changed, but it's mighty rare. And I don't think that's what most people are doing. Like, if you sit down to debate with Ben Shapiro, Ben Shapiro's not honestly trying to make the country better by doing that. That's just not how that works. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.